Okay. Good morning and welcome to the webinar organized within the WinterMed project. The WinterMed project is financed by the Interreg Med program with the European Regional Development Fund. The webinars we are organizing are dedicated mostly to good management practices for the development of sustainable and responsible tourism in Mediterranean islands. And today it's our last webinar for this summer period. It's 11th. This one addresses a very important theme for the sustainability policies in island destinations, and that is the mobility and its interconnections with the tourism sector. This good practice comes from Horizon 2020 funded Civitas Destination Project, and is about the shared mobility agency in touristic destinations that was implemented in Tuscany region on the Elba Island. Today we have a speaker that will present this experience. It is from Memex Group, that is a partner of Civitas Destination Project, Mr. Giorgio Ambrosino, that is the technical director of Memex Group. Just to inform you that we will have a question and answer session after this presentation. So we ask you to write down your comments and your questions for the speaker and in the chat box so we can read them after the presentation. In the meantime, we would just like to ask you to turn off your microphones and cameras, and this way we will leave a better quality of the connection during the presentation. So I would like to also present myself. My name is Lorena Vidas from ANCI Tuscany, and I will be coordinating this webinar today together with the colleague from Confesercenti Toscana that is partner of the project, Massimiliano Gini. So now I would like to leave the floor to Giorgio Ambrosino and his presentation.
Good morning all. Thank you, the Interreg Med Winter team for invite me. I am here, I am Giorgio Ambrosino, I am the director of Memex Company. I am with Eleonora Ercoli. Apologize by Saverio Gini that was not possible to be here. My presentation is about the shared use mobility agency and the Celso system implemented in Isola d'Elba inside of the European Civitas Destination Project. Okay, a few lines for Memex. Memex is an independent engineering consultancy company supporting mainly public transport authority and administration that was founded in 1904, the last century, and is very active in urban mobility, public transport, intelligent transport system, flexible transport service, and rural mobility, urban and ports, logistics, and all that you can see that all the issues that are going under the smart cities. Coming to the Civitas Destination project is a project that started founded under Civitas program, started in 2016, involve 29 partners, including China's partners, is demonstrated that there are six live laboratories in six islands. To make give some figures, we are at the present of in totally 1 million of inhabitants and more than 6 million of tourist visitors by year. The project was funded by 19 million of euro, and is targeted to deploy to demonstrate an integrated package for mobility solution for residents and tourists, clearly for more clean and decarbonized Iceland. In this slide, that is a little complicated, but I wanted to explain to you that at the first point, destination aim to answer to the mobility needs of residents and tourists. You know, because the islands are a place where to live also in not tourist season. It's clearly the six islands present different problems with respect to the level of tourists and the need of a resident. But they, apart Las Palmas, that is a great metropolitan area in one island, the other in Retimo, Limassol, Elba, there is the same problem. First of all, the non-relevance of public transport service, and second, the problems that they have with mobility and traffic, especially for parking, especially for congestion in the network, are similar to the small and medium town. From this, we have the mobility scenario that you know better than me, that now the mobility demand is more erratic than systematic. That is very difficult to to answer to this erratic this demand. From the other side, there is an emerging of asset shared service represented by transport network company. There is also a mutual interrelation between the tourist and the resident needs and requirements. Last point is very, very important, that in the last decade, the rule of virtual mobility, or more the information communication technology, including social media tools, is influencing much the stakeholders, the decision maker. Then, in the six laboratory of destination site, there was more than 80 measures to be tested, that including different categories. Mobility planning, improving public space, urban freight, shared mobility service, where is located the concept of the agency, mobility demand implementation, and public transport. It's clearly that destination is also oriented to the innovation. But the discussion in the project was also cover also what is the innovation. The innovation, we should define the innovation. What we should understand the meaning of innovation, we should understand the rule of innovation, we should understand the level of innovation. If you see this figure on the right, you see that a good picture where we see car sharing, where we see bicycle lane, but from the point of view of transport service, is not innovation, because the bus is not in priority line. You know that this could be innovation for the bike sharing or the car sharing, but from the point of view or the city or the public transport operator, could be that this picture is not innovation, that the innovation should be evaluated and based in different parameters that are organization, operation, planning, engagement, new business model and marketing, service scheme and product, impact and priority. It's clearly that the ICT is an enabler, is a component to supporting the solution of the problem, is not the solution. Then it's clearly the solution, the market present a large portfolio of technology, system and service. In this market, you could choose starting, for example, from the access control system to arrive on web and social tool for sharing a trip, or you start from car sharing for just arriving with electric vehicle or to the autonomous bus. But you know that this is the portfolio of the solution. The city should have the capability to choose and to pilot the solution. In that, based on this portfolio, in Civitas Destination, there was different technology, different ITS category. Memex was the responsible for the coordinator, the ITS level, the intelligent transport system level for each the six site, and also work at vertical level on the Porto Isola d'Elba site. First of all, in the first year of destination, there was the choose of the system more suitable to the site, and then this means K-evaluation decision design phase. Then there was a common work for design, the common functionality to be implemented. And the category of system that was useful to the each site was platform and tools for data aggregation, different data fusion, or different data analysis. There was in Limassol, Funchal, Malta, Elba, the development and the demonstration of InfoMobility app. There was also some site like Funchal, Las Palmas, Retirmo, focalized in developing payment systems and the control of this transport service on the road, on the network with automatic vehicle monitoring. There was also in Las Palmas and in Limassol, the oriented to electric demonstration and the team electric vehicle. And that is our presentation of today, the some site that they develop the ride and asset sharing, including Isola d'Elba, that develop the concept that I present today of ride sharing agency. And finally, there was some site oriented that developed and demonstrated some intelligent parking management system. That this is the scenario that in which the agency was developed in Isola d'Elba. You know that we cannot talk about the dimension of technology and the system if we don't consider, we should consider procedure, organization dimension, and business model. You know, this is a should be developed together with also a strong activity at two levels, the citizen engagement level and the stakeholders and public authority in define the support condition in terms of institutional, regulatory, and financial framework. I cannot to go on to present the concept of the agency if we don't take account our period of COVID-19 and what could be and what are the impact of COVID-19 in the transport service. You know, the first observation is we should contain, we should avoid the risk of a new rise of private car use, as we are seeing in this period after the lockdown. Surely we could say some consideration. First of all, we think that the municipality, especially in small and medium town, should come back a central rule about the overall mobility of the city, but also for the public transport service. The second is to put attention in space management. We need a policy of space management that with the priority of, first of all, safety for the pedestrian, and secondly, priority to collective service, including active service. This means to provide dedicated lane to this service. It's the space is the space is limited, and these resources should be well managed in favor of collective transport. There is also the need of integration occasional fleet, you know, because we saw that with the COVID constraints, we need to consider also other fleet in the overall public transport service, and to consider also the ride and asset sharing service part of the offer of mobility. We need to coordinate and to control this offer, the transport service offer, in different area. For this, we need two levels. The first is a common device for collecting and controlling the service, and the second is a new partnership business model. And in my presentation, agency could be an option for the small and medium town at minimum level. If we talk about ride and asset sharing, we should make a difference. You know, asset sharing service is a bike sharing service, as you see in many towns with a different scheme, free floating service or point-to-point service. It's like car share. The ride sharing is different. We should share the trip. We should share the ride. The first form of ride sharing service is the bus, because before the lock, the COVID-19 period, we were in 40 in one vehicle. 40 people in one vehicle, 40 people that share the same ride. From this board, the concept of shared use mobility agency. This means to pass from one service to the integration of the different ride sharing solution, and to integrate this with the mobility in the public transport service. It's clearly, in my opinion, that the ride sharing and especially the agency should be considered a mode integrated with the public transport service, and should be defined this mode in the urban mobility plan. It's clearly, as I told before, the information technology solution or platform are the condition for supporting this integration and this service. You know, Isola d'Elba is one of the laboratories. There are 32 inhabitants, but in the summer season, before, in the pre-COVID-19, there were more than 400,000 tourists in the summer. One of the good things, or could be a little complicated things, is that in this small island, there are 7 municipalities with 7 different approach on the mobility problems. And the island, there is two big port that guarantee the connection with the island. You see many problems or many characteristics of the island in front of the mobility and transport. I wanted to underline only 2 or 3 of these. That this means limited and narrow road network, dominance of a private car and motorbike, low use of public transport service. Only 40% of the overall trips are covered by the public transport service, with serious problem in the winter when the public transport should solve the problems of mobility of the residents. That, you know, with the 400,000 tourists that are arriving with the car, the problems and the main challenges is to act and to organize the transport service for giving the objective to have less use of car when the tourists remain or stay 1 week or 2 weeks in Isola d'Elba. Summarize this is that in Isola d'Elba, or like in Retimo, one of the other destination site, or like Limassol, there are problems similar to the problem that we have in Europe regarding the small town and rural area. The concept of agency is based and destroyed the level of technology that we are using. That first of all, the principle of the agency that is a center for coordination, managing and planning mobility rides service, for providing info mobility and for connecting and networking of operators, and support the administration of ELBA to understand the trends of the demand and the trends of the needs on mobility for the rest. It's clearly that we destroyed, as I told, some principle. First of all, with the social media and the personal ICT, the user could become also mobility service provider, that they can offer a trip, a passage to the user that make request. That the technology could help the cooperation and the networking among the different operators, especially the different transport service or the different ride sharing service. It's clearly, as I told you, that we need an IT platform for connecting and for managing the different data. And we defined a level of a notice board that is the level where, as I told before, some user, some citizen can look for a trip provided by a driver that offered the passage. You know that we say this in ELBA, we could integrate the different sharing service, but also with the different transport service and the different flexible transport service. More or less, the component of the IT platform are the open aggregated data layer that you can see here, the service operator networking, the transport service integrator, the infomobility service, the ride sharing notice board, the demand analysis tool, the service data accessibility and exposure that each transport operator can expose its offer on the mobility on mobility service, and the open data could allow the development of different applications for the third party developer if they want to use the data on transport and mobility. You know, here you have the architecture that we have the level of user that they could use web portal or app for connecting with the platform and also for use the notice board functionality. It's clearly there is a back office that the administrator could analyze the data or reporting the data. And this open data layer is manage the possibility to provide to be the base of data for the third part developer or to integrate the data coming from the different transport operator from the different transport service. In the next slide, I will concentrate to show you what means a notice board, what means a networking, and what means informality. But at the end, I will also describe the rule of the common tool for control and collecting data on the mobility service, possibility due by the Celso system demonstrated in Isola d'Elba. You know, notice board, sharing a trip, what means? What means that we have the possibility to connect the driver and the passenger that ask a trip, that we can use this functionality for sharing a trip when the user is on the ferry, that is looking for some driver that is going not to the destination port, but in one of the locality of Isola d'Elba, can planning the shared trip, or we can sharing the trip when the user is in a specific location or point of interest, like museum or beach. Sharing the tax call or trip, you know that they could share this, could go together to the taxi stops, or they could share the call for booking a taxi. You know that we developed also a sub functionality for the safety tracking when the trip was making by the user, and also the user safety certification. This that we can give the evaluation of the driver and the passenger. Here there are two of the many scenario and user case that was implemented, that you know that what I said before, the sharing the taxi trip, what means that making an agreement to go together with at the same taxi station at the same time, that they could share the cost of the taxi, or they go together to the taxi point, or they share the call when they are in some hotel and so on, and then they share the trip on taxi. The second is the same concept, but is dedicated to find a passage. They find a passage when the user are at the beach or at the museum, and to go together to the final destination. You know that the function is supported, the sub function, with the certification of who the driver that offer the passage, or the certification or in terms of safety and evaluation the passenger that make the request. Is similar to BlaBlaCar or other social tools of this type. The networking of the operator is more or less a simple layer, but you know, I joke with the simple layer, that where the service operator could expose their offer about, for example, the boat rental or the bike rental, or as old as we know, in the summer there are other parking place that could be managed near the beach. The operator, the parking owner, could expose the level of number of free slots that are available, or the other school rental. It's clearly that we make the networking of the operator by this level, but also we make the link to the reference of their website. You know that this is one of the show that we show the location where is the service and how to access to the service and the information. Also, as I told before, to link the website of the transport operator. You know, for the Infomobility service, we provide the possibility to make the multimodal trip planner. That this means that the mix of bus, ferry, and train when you arrive in Piombino, or to show the electric vehicle recharge point, or the rules about the limited traffic zone in each municipality, or where are the cycling lane. And we give also as not only the service location, but also the timetable, for example, for the bus service and the availability of the service. You know, this is the hub that is the front end from the user to the agency, that you see that there is also the possibility to give an opinion, an evaluation of the service, or the possibility to ask an opinion on some planned measure, that there is the ride service, travel diary, and so on. Yeah, this is the approach of the agency. The agency act in Isola d'Elba, but you know, is not alone. There are in Isola d'Elba different PT service and different schemes. As I told you, that in Isola d'Elba, there is the problem as a small town, and especially regarding the public transport use is under 14% of the operative. And as you remember, that one of the targets is to use less the car from the tourists when they are in Isola d'Elba. And you know that as in different area, there are different services: conventional public transport service, DEMA responsive transport service, school bus service, different seasonal public transport service, shuttle service. All these services need to be coordinated, need to be controlled, need to be to have information. Because if we go to see, we have three main actors that working on the public transport. There is the public authority that want to see if the conventional public transport sector comply with the performance that was subscribed with the transport operator. The transport operator wanted to have the idea where is how the service is going, which is the quality, and where are the services. The end user, it's they have the problem to access the service, to know the quality of the service, to see, to check the respect, the compliance with the timetable. That these three main actors, they have different problems or different questions, but they could have an unique solution that we in Isola d'Elba, we develop and we tested a system that in the seasonal service Marebus, but also in the seasonal service ferry, we use a common device, Celso system, that collecting data on the service, provide information to the user, collecting data and to allow to monitoring to the authority and the transport operator, to monitoring the timetable, to monitoring the quality of the service, to collect the data and to provide the user information with the app dedicated. This is was developed, and the architect was extended to the other service, as I told before, that the Celso was composed by three main component. One is the common device, the common app, collecting the data on the different service. A central control room that collecting the data and can planning, monitoring, management, and the data mining of this data. and to monitoring the service, different service. For example, the conventional, the flexible transport service, the school children service by the app, and to provide also user information, for example, where is the bus at this time, and the possibility to monitor also the location. You know, that this means that Celso perspective is to use as a common device for integration the different service of the different seven municipality, starting from the different summer service, but also to integrate the conventional service, the school bus service, and the feeder demand responsive transport service. These common tools will provide a central functionality that are included in the agency as a knowledge dashboard for planning and coordinating the different services. You know that this is the perspective, the agency that has a new component for monitoring all the typology of service developed in the ISLA and also supporting the authority, the operator and the user to check and to understand the performance of the service and to ask this service. You know, Celso was awarded as a seal of excellence by the SME H2020 program. And if you want to find further information and further explication and further detail on the shared use mobility agency, you can go to our website and you can discharge the booklet that we made in PDF version and was at your availability, as my personal ability to answer your question. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you Giorgio. It was very thoughtful presentation. Do you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so we have some comments already and also questions. I think it was very interesting. The first one is from, it says Giorgio Ambrosino, but it's probably one of your colleagues that comments with whom you shared your link for the connection. And it says, agree that ITS, integrated transport system, alone cannot provide a sustainable solution. Financial sustainability needs a sound business model. And in EU-funded New Bits project, we develop multi-stakeholder business model that return between 3 to 13 times the return of on investment. So we need the ITS to give us data to understand the demands to ITS service design. Do you agree? Can you comment on this model and say something more so we can, yeah?
I can say some things. Yeah. First of all, it's clear that the concept of agency could be declined in different way. Mm. You know, that you saw many components, but you could also start from one component, so that could be the notice board. Then the level of complexity of technology and organization that is behind could be decrease the level of complexity of this. It's clearly, in my opinion, Civitas program was a useful tool for seeing on this concept and realize this concept. But we need a business model that means who could manage this solution, the agency, and which could be the main function that could make a revenue. We make an estimation. In the booklet, you have three pages with the first hypothesis. One hypothesis is after the service operator could appreciate the benefit of the agency, they could pay a fee, for example, for be part of the networking and to expose their service. But I agree totally that this is an H 2020 also. There was innovation and there was simple solution. The agency was part of the innovation of the overall destination that we need. And the last month, we are discussing with the authority which could be the next 2 years of the agency for the organization aspect and the consolidation of the technology aspect.
Okay. So you need also to develop a business plan.
Already there is some idea and some main direction.
Okay. So the next comment is always from one of your colleagues, and it says the agency model is ideal model that brings all stakeholders together. Do you think cars coming onto the islands could be banned and that tourists could hire shared e-mobility cars as a public policy to ban the private transport?
Yeah. When I prepare the presentation of the agency, I would like to add also the another solution that was tested and positive demonstration. It was a Chelsea solution for the transport service. You know? Then it's clearly that the target that I told before is that in any case, the tourists, they arrive with the car. You know, that we need a regional, minimum regional approach for, and or also national approach, if the possibility that the major part of the tourists doesn't come with the car. But from the moment decided that they arrive with the car, the tentative is that they can use less the car. Because you know that in Isola del Bad there is before the COVID-19 last year, for example, a big congestion situation in Agos that the agency could support, but also we don't forget that we have the problem of residents in winter time, not only in summer but also all the year in winter. Then the agency with the notice board and with the coordination of the collective transport service could increase the efficiency of the overall transport. But we need to work.
Yeah. This is of particular interest to Wintermed project because actually we are developing strategies for all year round tourism in islands. So providing this kind of services during the winter also could help not only residents, but also bring some tourists that are not coming for only for sun and sea tourism.
Yeah, to extend the season.
To extend the season, sure. And I have a comment because you presented a set of tools and services that are really impressive. What do you think are the main difficulties and obstacles in putting them into practice?
Yeah, you know, this is, I am very happy that you made this question. You know what happened? I told you that Chelsea was used in the summer by small transport operator making the Marebus sea service, no? And then they have the driver and so on. In four hours, they learn to use the app on the board, and the technicians of Porto Ferraio and Rio Marina, they use as a backstage for the analysis and so on. But our surprise was that this January, we discovered that the Porto Ferraio team, they use Celso for the Christmas service without any intervention of Memex. They organize, they install that the app for the driver is running on the tablet. They define the route and so on. They have all the control of the Christmas service with the reporting for analyzing what was going well, what was wrong, and then they could analyze the service also for the next year, hoping that the COVID-19 could not have a negative impact on the mobility of tourists and residents. That was very easy to use. There is in destination a specific webinar to present in detail the Celso system. And the application in a school bus area, in a feeder service and seasonal service and demarestruzzi transport service.
Okay, great, thank you. So it's important to that the stakeholders can use it and also the probably the tourist offices and the agencies to know about these tools and applications so they can promote them.
Yes.
Yeah. We are discussing and promoting these good practices through these webinars, and the main aim is because we are working with several islands in the Mediterranean, and the interest of these islands is to implement these good practices. So the next question comes from Massimiliano, and he asked if a destination from another region wanted to implement this good practice, what would be needed from resources, financial, human resources, and what is already available by the Civitas Destinations projects for us?
Yeah, first the booklet is a good start point, because in the booklet there is the definition of the functionality, but not only with the title, but some detail specification, the first. The second is also the indication of the data, how to manage, how to have. There is also an hypothesis, as I told before, the business. The good practice could be starting from the booklet, then you know, we could have a step forward to discuss and to detail, you know, the comment. Yeah. Our hypothesis is in all the site of destination to have a common definition. Then the development could be rule of the administration that could be a small procurement for looking for local startup, for example, to develop the related software, you know. From the financial and investment, our platform that was procured by procurement, all the platform that was very, very complex platform, but as I told you could see also the agency more simple, because more simple architecture was procured with the resources of the destination project around 100-120 kilo euro.
Okay.
But a direction. Then using the common specification and thinking on the objective that the single island they have, there is a different resource.
Okay, yeah, I understand. So we have a question now from Cristina from Institute for Agriculture and Tourism from Poreč, Croatia. And her comment is that it looks complicated, all this. So how did you involve local stakeholders, and are they willingly participating, or you have some additional methods to convince them to participate? in this project.
To be honest, from the presentation seem more complicated that I suggest Cristina to read the booklet that I can, but I can agree and make two examples. The first example, we already organize the testing of the notice board and the app in a school district of Portoferraio, as we are used to do also in other experience, like for example Interreg Motivate, where we a class of the district, the pupils, the students, they prepare, they make an analysis of the app, and then in large assembly, in large meeting with all the students, we collect all the comments from the easy to use to the results of the app, in this case a notice board, that we are now organizing this kind of testing for the Portoferraio. I agree that could be the two different. Chelsea is more use the agency is a platform from the technology point of view, with all the benefit and all the complexity that has.
So probably the public authorities have their interest in order to manage better the transport, and also the private transport companies need to connect in order to develop better services for.
Yeah.
If they see a positive business model for them, I think it's the best solution how to involve them.
Yes,
probably.
Yes, I agree. You know that, for example, it's clearly, for example, in there are two levels. The first level for the controlling the service and so on, you could put the request to have the collecting data in the procurement of the service that the operator is obliged to use some tools, not specific tools you like chats, but you in your procurement for the service of the next summer or the service of school bus, you should put in the procurement document as a requirement the use of some simple COM tool that without any reference tools. Which tools, but this. From the platform point of view, the agency, I see that, as we discussed previously, that I see that we need a business model, that we need that a small company could manage the IT and all the service together. You know, there could be a specific procurement for managing the agency.
Okay, thank you. I think it's quite clear. We have another question. Chelsea looks like a useful tool to develop multimodal solutions. Can it assist operators in times of COVID restrictions to maximize capacity of vehicles?
Yeah, you know, as I told you that there is a specific webinar, and then you can discharge also in the destination website or in our website that provide the utility of Celso in answering the COVID-19 constraints. First of all, allow the booking of the seat. You know, and secondly, help to the driver to communicate if the small bus is at the occupancy level defined. It's clearly, for example, that see the last new around Europe, we are going to decrease this occupancy constraints to that I saw that now in Italy, for example, is a lowered 60% of the official number that each bus could bring. But in Celsio could help the different constraints to answer to the different constraints that we already developed some specific functionality.
Yeah, sure. The destinations really need these tools now, and it's a good thing that we already have tools that are developed and can be used for this, then go from the scratch and start all over again. So we have another comment question. The old still works in Piombino. Piombino is a city in Tuscany, in the coast. Could be developed as park and ride for ferry. Is this an option?
This is a discussion we had during also destination that to organize the possibility that the people coming, if I understood the question, coming by car, they could leave the car in Piombino and then they go with the ferry. You know, in my opinion, that since more than 40 years working in mobility and transport, if you arrive in Piombino, you never leave the car in Piombino. If you don't put the official regulation that you cannot come in the Isola d'Elba, like in Capri or so, without car. That the problem we discussed many times, it's clearly that is a problem that to be solved at minimum level, regional level, and the other authority, Piombino and Isola d'Elba municipality. That this was the motivation we at the beginning of the destination we set. You come with the car, but please you don't use the car. You use less the car when you stay normally 7 days in Isola d'Elba.
Yeah, of course.
It's easy to say, okay, we make a park in Piombino. And but in practice we are here. We say these things 20 years ago and then we are always here.
At the same point. Of course, if we don't allow cars on the island, we need very, very well developed transport services. Otherwise, will not come.
And we also check what the Piombino residents and authorities
think about it. About yes. Sure. Okay, I think this is it. Your colleague presented himself. Sorry, I did not register in time, and thanks for allowing me to share Memex screen. Brian Mason, MMTS Scotland. Reasons for the questions coming through Memex name. So we now have the name behind the questions.
Rena, do you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, Gorana.
Sorry to intervene, but can I just say a few words? Because just a few weeks ago, we just got information regarding Civitas destination that our pilot area, Island Corcula, is collaborating. The tourist office of Island Corcula, I mean the city Corcula, is collaborating with Civitas destination to transfer this type of mobility service on the island. So they will maybe not transfer or everything that it is presented. They wanted to make tourists to come to the island, and maybe through type of tourist card, if you use public transportation, or if you use bikes, if you use green transportation, you get some discounts in some accommodation and to other tourist services on the island. And I just met the procurist and the director of the tourist office, and we invited them to this webinar, but I'm really sorry, I don't know why didn't they participate today, because I wanted them to to have a word and to tell how did they plan to do this. And it's really good thing because now we have WinterMed project and we have this other project that is connecting the same area.
You know that the concept of the agency, you know, was implemented in Isola d'Elba. For me, was I am very happy because this concept we elaborate many years ago, before also to the destination, that you can find some reference to my book and so on. And in the concept, of, as I told you, that the agency, you could choose some functionality. For example, in the general concept, but also specified, there was the coordination integration of the payment of the service and based on, for example, tourist card that could be awarding awarding policies for using clean and active service or to integrate to pay with the card or with the mobile phone the different service without to facilitate the ticketing system, you know. And from the other side, if I understood your intervention, it's clearly that working, there is seven municipality, there is an association that you say from the municipality, that it's good to, that your approach that that you could interest to inform them also the other solution. For example, in Funchal, what do you say? The Funchal is the lead of the destination. They work very hard in integration ticketing and so on, as in Las Palmas.
Thank you, Mr. Ambrosina.
So as I understood, Gorana, Korčula is not one of the main pilot areas of Civitas Destination, but they were interested in transferring this good practice.
They are doing that. They were here in our office just a week ago, and they were like talking to us about this project. And then I got it got on my mind that at Civitas Destination is something that is, you know, ringing in my ear. So I checked the webinars and I said, okay, this is the same thing. It's the same project. Please participate if you can. But I'm really sorry. I don't know why didn't they participate today so we can get this story, I mean, even more detailed.
Yeah. Yeah, it will be also interesting. We will meet probably, hopefully, very soon in Korčula, so also to
hopefully,
hear from them. Hopefully, yes. Let's see. But then if we meet in Korčula, then it will be great if they could speak about
probably,
their experience.
Probably, yes, because there are partners, and they will probably be very interested to give us also something about this input about this part.
Yeah, you know that as I told that as MEMEX we coordinate all the specification and design of the different systems, and vertically there was also the integration of payment system, tourist card, and so on, you know. And then we provide assistance on all the site on this that we could discuss on this. We are available also.
Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, Gorana, for your comments. And thank you, Giorgio. If we don't have, I think we finished the question. I don't know if anybody else wants to intervene, or otherwise, I think we can close also the discussion. I would like also to thank very much Giorgio because it was very interesting, and it's a very important theme, the mobility for especially for the islands and the difficulties of interconnections. So I think this experience and this good practice will be very valuable to our partner partners and stakeholders from involved regions in WinterMed project. I would like to inform the participants that don't know already that all our webinars, and it's 11 now, are available, and the last one will be available the next days from the project's website and YouTube channel. So if you know that some of your stakeholders couldn't attend today and for past webinars, you can just share with them the links and they can go over all these good practices, and hopefully it will help them to manage better their destinations. So thank you all, and thank you, Giorgio, for the presentation. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye-bye.